when we are talking about bitwise operators, they only are working on two kinds of data, only character and integer variables where they will work. They will not work with any other data type. So the bitwise operations will only work on character or integer. Bitwise operators are AND, bitwise OR, bitwise NOT or negation or complement, bitwise XOR, left shift bitwise operator, right shift bitwise operator. I will say that this is bitwise AND, OR, complement, this is XOR, bitwise left shift operator, and bitwise right shift operator. So these are the kind of bitwise operators which are available. Why are they bitwise operator? Let us try to understand. Supposedly I'm having an integer A is equal to 10 and supposedly B is equal to 20. I'm having two integers here. Now what happens is I am trying to do a bitwise operation. So I am printing C out. I'm printing A and B. So what will happen in this case? In this case, it is going to give me an output which is the bitwise operation. What do I mean by bit? Now let us see what do I mean by bits. Let us convert A into binary. What is A? A is 10. 10 into binary is, if I am assuming that this is 2 bytes of data, or even if I am assuming 4 bytes of data. So when you are representing 10, it is 10 is represented as 1010.
Yes, ma'am.
And here 0000 and other 00s will be there. If you have 4 bytes, then there will be 4. I am taking just 8 bits for reference. The last 8 bits, pehle wali to sari 0 hi hongi na. So I am not taking them into consideration right now. This is A because this is 10 and B is 20. So 20, if you are going to represent, how is 20 represented? So you will have to do the conversion. I have forgotten. If you are trying to convert, you keep on dividing it and keep on reading the remainders in the opposite manner. So it is 10100. So it comes 10100 and you have 3 other zeros here. So this is how you will be representing A and B in bits. Now when I am having A and B, then AND, as all of you already know, that if both the bits are 0, the answer is a 0. Both the bits are 0, the answer is a 0. Both the bits are 0, the answer is a 0. One of the bits is 1, answer is again 0. Jab tak both the bits are 1, the answer will remain 0. This is AND operation. So 1 and 0 will give you 0. 0 and 1 will also give you 0. 1 and 0 will again give you 0, and 0 and 0 will again give you 0. So technically 10 and 20 bit wise will give you 0 in the output. Are you all able to understand bit wise AND operation?
Yes, ma'am.
You yes, all ma'am. Know AND ke case mein that if I am drawing the truth table for the output, 00 pe 0, 01 pe 0, 10 is again 0, 11 is 1. Only you get a 1 when both the bits are 1, only then the output is 1. So here there is never the time when both of the bits are 1. So corresponding bits pe AND hua hai. Corresponding bits pe. So you are getting a 0 in the output. So output of A and B should be 10. Similarly, let's try to see if this is A or B. If this was A or B, then what should be the output in that case? Now if I am having A or B, so the truth table for OR is, whenever you are having a 1, the output will be 1. Whenever one of either of the inputs is 1, the output will become 1. So let's try and see here. This is 0. 0 and 0 is 0. 0 or 0 is 0. 0 or 1 is 1. 1 or 0 is again a 1. 0 or 1 is again 1. 1 or 0 is again 1. 0, 0 is 0. Now you have to convert it back to decimal and then find out. To convert it back to decimal, again the same formula that you have been using. 2 raised to the power 0 plus 2 raised to the power 1. 2 raised to the power 1 into all of these you are doing. 2 raised to the power 3. and 2 raised to the power 4. Rest are 0, so I'm not interested. So this becomes clearly 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16. 2 plus 4, 6 plus 8 is 14 plus 16 is 30. So you should be getting 30. 10 or 20. 10 or 20 should give you 30 as an answer. Is it clear? Bitwise or? It is not 14, Kanika. Correct it to be 30. Fine. You are adding these, you will get the same answer. Fine. Keep on adding, you will be getting the same answer. Now, supposedly it is a bitwise XOR. I am taking XOR first. Let us understand what is the XOR table. XOR is going to give me the same output. That is why I am taking XOR. XOR means whenever there is an odd number of 1, the output is 1. Whenever there is even number of 1 or 0, the output is 0. So you have to have odd. XOR is exclusively OR. Exclusively OR mein, if either of the bits is 1, the output is 1. If both of the bits are same, then the output is 0. Agar dono bits same hai, to output 0 hai, alag-alag hai, then the output is 1. In this case again, 0 is 0, 0 XOR 0 is 0, 0 XOR 0 is 0, 0 XOR 1 is 1. 1 XOR 0 is again 1. 0 XOR 1 is again a 1. 1 XOR 0 is again a 1. 0 XOR 0 is again a 0. So if I am using XOR, then A XOR B in this case will give you the same answer as 30. Is it clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now supposedly I want to print complement of A. So I'll remove B from here for the time being. So what do I mean by complement of A? All of you understand that complement when we are doing, we will be taking a complement means 0 turns to 1 and 1 turns to 0. 0 turns to 1 and 1 turns to 0. So this is the complement that we should be getting. Now this complement is representing, since it's of type integer, it can have negative numbers of numbers also. And since all, isse pehle ke jitte bhi zeros hai, all will be one only. So this is representing a negative number which will be stored in 2's complement form. So I have to find out what is the 2's complement form over here. So ek iska 2's complement hai, to be able to find that, then only we can see that it is stored in the correct manner. So if I want to try to find out the 2's complement form for it, so let us see. If you try to run this, the output that you will be getting is minus 11. Let's try to find ki minus 11 ki 2's complement form ye hai ya nahi. So if you represent 11, if you are representing 11, it is 1101000. This is what 11 is in binary. Take 1's complement of it. 1's complement means it will come 1111010. This is what 1's complement form will come. Yes or no?
Yes,
sorry, yes, 1011 is 1011 is 11. 1010 is 10. 1011 is 11. I wrote the binary wrong. Kindly correct it. So this is the 1's complement form. 0 becomes 1, 1 becomes 0. Correct? Now add 1 to find the 2's complement form. So whatever I am getting, this is my 2's complement form. So if I am adding 1, it becomes 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is 2's complement of 1. 2's complement of 11 is equal to minus 11. 2's complement of 11 is the minus 11 representation. This is how we represent data. Is this same? Can you find that this is the same? Yes, this is the same. That means this is the 2's complement form of minus 11. So if you are trying to find the complement of A, it will give you minus 11 because it is happening on bits. Complement of A, in when you will be converting it back to integer, whatever is there, if the first element is a 1, it is the 2's complement form of a negative number. So it will convert it using the 2's complement arithmetic and it will show you minus 11 as the answer. To find the complement of the number 10, the number 10 in binary is represented as 00001010. अगर 4 byte का integer है तो ये सिर्फ 1 byte show हो रही है, इसके पहले की 3 bytes क्या होंगी 00000, ठीक है? This is only 8 bits that I am representing here. The rest of the 3 bytes, that means rest of the 24 bits would be 00000. If I want a complement of this number, A is 10. If I want the complement of A, if I want to find out, then every bit, every 0 is converted to 1, every 1 is converted to 0. All the bits before this, again, they will become 1. Now, when I am having the initial number as 1 in integer, that means it is a negative number and it is stored in 2's complement form. What do I mean by 2's complement form? Kisi bhi number ki 2's complement form is calculated as 1's complement plus 1 bit. Ye hoti hai 2's complement form. Ab ye number kaun sa, if I want to find it, so I can do the reverse. I will minus 1 and do the complement. So I will get ki kis number ki 2's complement form hai. So if I am doing a minus 1, I get 1111 will be same there in all others. This is what I will be getting. If I reduce a single digit, minus 1 is getting here. And if I now take a complement of this, this is the answer. But what answer will be there in decimal that I am trying to find out? So if I am taking a complement, all will be now 0. This is just the pehle hai, wo bhi. This becomes 1011. This I can find what it is in decimal. 2 raised to the power 0 plus 2 raised to the power 1 plus 0. I am not considering 2 raised to the power 2 was missed. So this is 2 raised to the power 3. So I have 8 plus 2. Plus 1. This gives me 11 in decimal. That means this which I am getting is 2's complement form of 11. So my final answer that I am getting here will be minus 11. Is it now clear how we are storing negative numbers in 2's complement form in the computer? So in complement of A, if I am trying to print this value, I will get minus 11 as an answer.